Hi everybody, welcome. Today I want to share with you a week of meals for our family of three. I love to do a lot of homemade from scratch cooking, and I thought it would be fun to share what we eat. I know in some of my homemaking videos you get to see one of the meals or a lunch and a supper, but I just want to share with you what we ate this past week actually for our evening meals. And so included in that was like a New Year's Eve meal, and then using some leftovers from like Christmas ham and stuff like that that we had given to us from my parents. So that made it nice to have some extras. But I'm gonna share with you and show you what we have made this past week. So day one, we had split pea and ham soup. Now, split pea soup is one of those meals or foods that you either like or you don't like. Our family loves it. It's a super affordable meal to make. I just buy the bag of split peas, and I did it on the stovetop. You can do it in the Instant Pot, you can do it in a slow cooker, but since I'm home, it was really nice just to do it all on the stovetop. So I just sauteed some carrots, onions, celery, and some olive oil in my Dutch oven. I love my Dutch oven and my cast iron. I cook with those several times a week, and got those going. And then I added some broth in there and the split peas, and it cooked for probably several hours or an hour, hour and a half, and honestly just mushes up on its own. It does not look appetizing, but it sure tastes good. And then I seasoned it, of course, like salt, pepper, garlic, the things that I often use with most of my cooking, and it was so delicious. Added the ham that I had pre-chopped, and that just added a nice touch of flavor. I did run out of chicken stock, so I made sure to add enough water and then just a little more seasoning because it started to lack flavor. So it's nice to have enough of the chicken broth or chicken stock so that it has an adequate amount of flavor. And then my mom had given us some homemade bread, so we toasted some homemade bread along with that soup, and it was just a super simple, delicious weeknight meal. Okay, day two, Tuesday nights are usually our Mexican nights. So I made a Mexican casserole of sorts with a side salad. And this recipe, I'll link, if I got the recipes online, I'll link them in the description box for you. I did do a lot of adjustments. I don't ever really cook to what recipes tell you. I kind of do things my own way somewhat. So for this one, I browned a pound of hamburger and onion, of course, in there, and then garlic. And then I put them in a like 8x8 glass pan. It did say 9x13, so I halved the recipe. We still had quite a bit left over just because we're a family of three. So if you had a lot more people in your family, go with the bigger cookware. So with this casserole, I then layered some corn tortillas. You can use flour, whole wheat, it's up to you. So I used my corn tortillas, and I put a layer of refried beans, and then another layer of corn tortilla, and then that's where the meat, and then I had a can of diced tomatoes with green chilies in it, so it added a bit of a spice. So my little daughter wasn't too keen on the spice, but if you add enough Greek yogurt as your sauce or sour cream, whatever you want when you serve it, and cheese, that masks the spice a little bit. And then I added cheese on there, and then I just kind of did that again and layered it a few times. I added some black olives just to make it a little more Mexican, and then we served it with some salsa and chips too, and it just was really pretty good. I'd never made it before, but it was a very simple meal to make, and if you have some sort of canned tomato or even home canned tomatoes, which I also have, you could use that as well. So for day three, that is our breakfast for supper meal, I made a veggie and ham egg bake with some Morning Glory muffins and a fruit smoothie. So these egg bakes are so simple. It's kind of just throw in any veggies you want. I sauteed the vegetables, so like mushrooms, peppers, onions. You could put tomatoes in it. You can put spinach in it. It's really up to you. And then eggs, and I don't measure real well. I added milk. You could put half and half in there, heavy cream. You could just do eggs, and then I also shredded some sharp cheddar and some mozzarella and put that in there. And the mozzarella, I had not done that before, but that was really a nice touch to the egg bake. And I then did the Morning Glory muffins, and I do not ever recommend hand grating carrots if you can avoid it. If you have a food processor, something that shreds them, I shredded my carrots in less than 30 seconds. It was super fast because these muffins have a lot of nutrients in it, and they're really truly quite a healthy muffin with carrots, apples, raisins. I used whole wheat flour, coconut oil. Like I said, I'll link all those in the description box because this muffin recipe, it was just so good. My husband loved it and my daughter loved it. So I had those muffins made, and then I did my egg bake, and then added a little more cheese halfway through the process. And then I blended up a banana blueberry yogurt smoothie to go along with it. So really, I love having breakfast or supper. I don't know if any of you guys do that, but this is just a fun way to change up what you're having. Okay, day four was New Year's Eve. So we just had a really small gathering. I did a slow cooker pulled pork with some coleslaw and a homemade coleslaw dressing and some roasted sweet potatoes and then some brownies. Now the brownies, I honestly have to say, did not turn out how I was expecting. They were super dry. I don't like using boxed brownie mix. If you have to do that, that's great. That's really fine. But I did try a homemade. And they just really didn't turn out as well. With ice cream on top, they weren't too bad. But for the pulled pork, this recipe has been one I found a couple years ago, and I just love the recipe. It cooks for about 10 to 12 hours, so I stuck it in the morning, and it's got like a soy sauce. I use liquid aminos instead of soy. Balsamic vinegar, garlic. It's just so good to have that flavor as it's cooking the whole day, and it makes your house smell wonderful. So that was the pulled pork, and then I just had some frozen Rhodes brand buns that I let rise and had those fresh out of the oven when we had the pulled pork. And coleslaw, I had bought a head of cabbage, and it must have been rotten from the inside out because I tasted it and it was just awful. And it already made my coleslaw up, so had to have my husband buy a pre-made mix because it was like right before supper time. And then I did a Greek yogurt sauce for the coleslaw dressing. And then I just roasted some sweet potatoes with olive oil, salt, and pepper. And that is a hit with the friends we have and my whole family. So that was a really simple New Year's Eve meal to have. All right, and then Friday nights are always pizza nights. Sometimes we have store-bought Aldi pizza, but tonight was a homemade sourdough crust pizza. And we had some leftover pulled pork, so I used some of that with some barbecue sauce. And then we had artichoke hearts. I love artichoke hearts, I just don't usually buy them. And so we had that on there as well. I sauteed some onions and peppers and mushrooms. I feel like I'm always sauteing onions, peppers, and mushrooms, but they're just so good, so flavorful. And then I had a store-bought pizza sauce. If you have homemade, that's great, that's awesome. And then I had some pepperonis, I shredded some mozzarella cheese, and voila, you really have a really simple meal. And the crust I've used for several years, it's from Farmhouse on Boone. So I'll link that also in the description box. And then of course, just a side salad, which is super simple, nothing too fancy. So I really think these meals are very doable if you've got a little bit of time. I mean, some of them are less than half an hour for sure. But hopefully it motivates you or encourages you to cook from home, from scratch, and then gives you some ideas for meals. Like I said, I do theme some of my days, and I just think that really helps so that my family knows and I know if I didn't actually meal plan, that I know what kind of theme I'm going to be having for that day. If you like this type of video, give it a thumbs up. I would love to do more what we eat in a week videos if you are interested in those. If not, I do, like I said, some of my meals in my homemaking videos as well. But hope you have a blessed and wonderful day. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't been and you've been watching and are enjoying these. I will talk with you in my next video next week. All right, bye.